Bump here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to blanch sand fleas. Blanching sand fleas before freezing will keep them fresh and prevent them from falling apart when you put them on a hook for fishing. Of course, sand fleas are arguably the best bait for surf fishing or fishing from the beach. They're a great bait for pompano, whiting, redfish, black drum, just about any fish you can catch in the surf zone. The first step in blanching sand fleas is to thoroughly rinse the sand fleas. You want to just use regular tap water to remove any excess sand from the sand fleas and give them a thorough cleaning. Next, you'll want to prepare two large pots, one with boiling water and another with ice water. Then we're going to add our sand fleas to the boiling water. When you first pour the sand fleas in, they should sink to the bottom, and then the blanching process only takes about 30 seconds to a minute. As they begin to blanch, the sand fleas will float up to the top and will have an orange pinkish hue. When they float to the top and the color has changed, you know that they're done. After you've blanched your sand fleas, we're going to transfer them from the boiling water over to the pot of the ice water. The ice water is going to quickly cool down the sand fleas and stop the cooking process. Again, your sand fleas are going to be floating and should have that real nice orange bright hue when they've completed the blanching process. Then we're going to leave our sand fleas in the ice bath for several minutes to allow the cooling process to complete. At the end of the cooling process, the sand fleas should sink back down to the bottom of the pot, just like they were at the beginning of the blanching process. Then you're going to be left with just the ice floating at the top of the ice bath, which we can remove and then go on to strain the sand fleas. Next, we're going to strain our blanched sand fleas to separate them from the water. We want to remove as much water as possible before freezing. This will prevent ice crystals from forming in the freezer and for the sand fleas to start getting freezer burn. So we want to get as much water out as we can so that the sand fleas will be preserved for as long as possible when freezing. Getting the sand fleas completely dry is a little less important if you think you'll be using the bait in the immediate future. If you're going to be storing the bait for a long period of time, I recommend completely drying the bait out before freezing. Once you've completely dried out the blanched sand fleas, you're simply going to transfer them to freezer bags for storage in the freezer. If you're blanching a lot of sand fleas, you may want to do this outside as it can produce a smell. The smell is going to be similar to if you were to boil shrimp or lobster or other crustaceans. Finding sand fleas can be tough in the wintertime, and it can even vary wildly from beach to beach. Recently I was surf fishing Siesta Key. All the beaches north of the Point of Rocks on Siesta Key are very fine and white, compact, and have a lot of shells. It's very difficult to find sand fleas on these beaches. On the south side of Point of Rocks, beaches like Turtle Beach, which are just 2 miles away, are much different. The sand is much darker and fluffier, and sand fleas are readily available. When sand fleas are plentiful or readily available, it's a good idea to go ahead and stock up, blanch your fleas and freeze them for those days where it's a little tougher to find sand fleas, or you don't have time or don't feel like searching for bait. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up down below and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, while you're here, check out this really neat video of catching sand fleas at night using UV light.